We wrap up 2 weeks of our NFL draft review with Phil Savage, the executive director of the Reese's Senior Bowl. And our final position, Phil, is the defensive backs, cornerbacks specifically. And our highest pick, the Saints, go up and grab one of those big corners.
Yeah, Stanley Jean Baptiste out of Nebraska. And this is an absolute reaction to what's going on in their division. Carolina Panthers take Kelvin Benjamin out of Florida State, 6'5", 240. Tampa Bay grabs Mike Evans from Texas A&M, 6'5", 231, to go alongside Vincent Jackson. And then, of course, the Falcons return Julio Jones and Roddy White. So the Saints react and take Stanley Jean Baptiste, 6'3", 220-pound corner out of Nebraska. He may be expected to play this year.
A Reese's Senior Bowl bump. This is the player who came to Mobile and really improved his stock. Who would that player be?
Well, Walt Akins out of Liberty University was one of the standout players at the Medal of Honor game, which is another all-star game a few weeks before the Reese's Senior Bowl. And so we grabbed him out of that game. He's a 6 foot corner, 203 pounds, played basketball, ran track, and participated on the football team for the Flames. He goes to the Miami Dolphins in the fourth round, and I think that they will find him to be a very interesting prospect as they try to rebuild that secondary.
Now, of all the defensive backs, the corners that were here, who can jump in and provide immediate help?
You know, I think the one player that really stood out to me during the season at the East-West Shrine Game, and then he got an invite to the Reese's Senior Bowl, and he's just very active, feisty, knows how to get the ball on the ground, is Nevin Lawson from Utah State. So he goes to the Detroit Lions. Obviously, they're in a division where the ball is in the air with Green Bay and Chicago in specific. And if Minnesota can sort through their quarterback issues, they have some weapons as well. But the Lions have had some injury issues, and they've not had a lot of success in the defensive secondary in terms of homegrown talent. So I think Nevin Lawson has a chance to be a sleeper in that fourth round area that can get on the field as a nickel slot corner this season.
How about value? Which player is going to bring the most value with their pick?
Well, you know, I like what the Browns did. At the fourth round and 127th pick overall, they take Pierre Desir out of Lindenwood. 25 career interceptions in college. He, again, is one of these lengthy, long-armed corners. And again, with what they did in the first round, taking Justin Gilbert to pair off with Joe Hayden, they've got Buster Skrine. Now they also have added Pierre Desir to add another element on the perimeter of their defense. So I think that this could be a real value for them down the road.
Okay. And finally, your spotlight choice. This is a player. Just keep an eye on this guy.
Well, spotlight for us was, of course, Aaron Colvin out of Oklahoma. Was having a terrific week of practice. Slated to probably go in the second round. Tears his ACL in practice in a coverage drill on air. And yet, he ends up being taken in the fourth round by the Jacksonville Jaguars. We don't know if he will be redshirted this year or not. He certainly made a lot of progress. But down the line, probably 2015 and beyond, he's got a chance to be a starter in Jacksonville. A very good player and a better person. He handled himself with a lot of grace and dignity through a very difficult circumstance. Ends up being a fourth round selection. He and his family, very happy. We're very happy for him.
Well, of course, Jacksonville Jags coach Gus Bradley, who coached him here, saw his ability in just a day or two, saw him at the combine and said, hey, we're going to come and get you. And sure enough, they got him.